Well done, kiddo. Now that is what I call a success.
Thanks, Harry.
Well, I have to say, I wouldn't have bet on it.
Bet it this way, right? Surprise, surprise.
Yeah, sure. You know what we should do? We should print a few copies of your songs for the next gig. I got you a recording session at the studios here. Look, Mr. DeMeo, he couldn't make it, but he sends his regards. He said he'll meet you in the week.
Oh, that's a shame. Please send him my regards too.
Santo, you were great!
Lynn!
Won't you introduce me to your nice lady, Santo?
Oh, sorry. Of course. Lynn, this is Harry, my manager.
Hello, sir. Pleased to meet you.
Hello, Lynn. Now, you look familiar. Haven't we met before?
No, sir. I don't think so.
Yeah. Aren't you the one who makes them delicious cakes down Gerrard Street?
Yeah, that's right. Her cakes are the best.
Santo, I see you're busy. I'll leave you with your manager. I'll see you soon.
Hey, wait, could you just give me just 5 minutes?
Santo, there's a journalist friend of mine who wants to meet you.
That's fine. Don't worry about me. Go, meet the journalist. See you.
Wait. What? What happened? Did I say something wrong?
Oh, you know women. They always want all the attention. Let's get the fuck out of here. You'll see her tomorrow. Rocco's waiting to meet us down at Bianchi's. Hey, Aldo, how are ya? This is Santo. Oh, boy. He just gave a great show down the Marquee, you know? You'll hear about him soon.
Oh, that's a good. We love music here. Rocco is sitting over there. What can I bring you?
Bring us some of that pasta and fagioli, you mate, would ya? The one that makes you fart all night. We gotta celebrate here.
Va buono. Okay, a little wine too, right?
Si, si, grazie.
Ah, bravo, guaglio.
I knew you'd be a hit, kid. I knew it.
I should thank you, Rocco. I'm sorry if I reacted badly, but everything was so sudden and surreal.
You know, he looks big and dumb, but actually, he's quite clever. And he's got a soft heart. He's the only ogre I know who likes to help children.
Shut up! If I have to break your neck, I will. You watch it.
Santo, you'll see. The pasta e fagioli they make here is the best. You know, one day, Rocco had so much of it, Mr. DeMeo had to kick him out of his office.
No way. Why?
He couldn't stop doily carting. It sounded like we was under attack.
Oh, really?
So, Mr. DeMeo goes, Rocco, so you really are an arsehole after all. Get the fuck out of my office. And Rocco says, how did you say, Rocco? Oh, I apologise, Mr. DeMeo. I'm just practising my fiction.
Practising my diction, you idiot. Yeah. Not fiction.
yeah, anyway, yeah. Mr. DeMeo, he looks at him in a way, well, I can't even describe. It was hilarious. Yeah, I tell you, boy, we do have some fun sometimes. We love to wind him up. He's a good man. He raises all, you know. We came here with nothing out of the war, and he gave us roof, food, yeah, and a good job.
You know, he reminds me of my grandfather. But Grandma, she was not as sexy as this woman, to be honest.
You mean Pixie? Ah, she's just a slut. And he knows it. Can't even cook a thing. But she makes him feel young. That's all. But he really loved his wife, you know.
Oh, he had a wife? And what happened?
They was living in Scotland. One day she suddenly ups and left him for a richer geezer. Took their daughter. She just disappeared.
That's awful.
Well, yeah, he was gutted. So he came to London to start a new life.
Well, okay, but didn't he try to find her?
Oh, yeah, he did. When he made his money, he hired a private detective. He found out his daughter had moved here. So he bought her a club just to show he could provide. Nothing changed, though.
That must be so hard to swallow.
Yeah, it still pains him. He tried to reconnect with his wife many times. Even asked his daughter to help, but nothing.
How could his daughter be so ungrateful?
Life's a bitch, kid. And women, well, they can be too.
Oh, look, Larry's here. Larry, we're over here, you dry ravioli.
Hey, Riccio.
Here, sit down, mate, sit down. We've ordered some ammo for you, too.
Oh, Aldo's pasta fagioli. Great a choice.
So, how you doing? I guess you're already familiar with our Vinnie.
Oh, yes. Great show, kid. You got enough balls to fill a tennis court.
He's good, isn't he?
Big voice for such a tiny guy. If I didn't look at him, Maron, I would have said there was a 6-foot-tall singer on stage.
Oh, thanks. Are you Italian too?
Si, si. Cumi Lello.
Lello? Why Larry then? Is it like a stage name?
Stage name, that's a good one. Well, in a way, yes.
You know, after the war, many Italians needed a moody name if they wanted to get a decent job.
That's right. Churchill set the tone for us in 1940. Collar the lot, he said. Thousands were arrested and sent to detention camps. Many died. It was because of Mussolini.
Oh, I see. I wasn't even born back then.
Well, Lello hasn't told you the entire truth, though. In his case, it wasn't just because of Mussolini.
What do you mean?
Yeah, what do you mean?
Well, his surname is, Macaroni!
Really? Your name is Lello Macaroni?
Well, yes. Okay, come on, enough. Enough. It's not my fault, is it?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm sorry, mate. Sorry.
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, let's talk business. I already sent the article for tomorrow's paper.
An article?
Yes, Soho News. It will help you.
Oh, great. Grazie, Lello.
You can thank Harry. I owe him one. Salute.
Salute.
Buonanotte, everybody.
Ciao, Larry.
Hey, ciao, Macero. Give us a shirt every once in a while, yeah?
And you stay out of trouble, all right? Seeing friends in jail makes me sad. And I wouldn't know how to make you a cake anyway.
Won't you go and get laid? It'd do you good. Always holding that pen. Such a lonely business.
Yeah. But you know, the pen is mightier than the sword.
Hey, Rocco was right about Bianchi. I haven't eaten so well since I moved over here.
Well, kid, you will have to get used to it if things go the way we think. All the important people eat there, you know.
Harry, watch out!
What?
Do you remember me, you son of a bitch? Do ya?
What the fuck, mate? You got prettier.
Shut it, pig. You keep out of it, kid.
Seriously, jail time's done you good. Let's go out on a date.
This gun is your date, you fucking arsehole.
Great line. Do you want to do another 20 years? Maybe they'll show you for life this time.
Who cares? I don't have a fucking life anymore, nor do you.
Santo, he'll sick you.
Shut up.
What?
He'll sick you, I said.
Ah, si.
Shut up, you cunt.
Give it to me, big boy. I like it rough.
You're a sick piece of shit.
Ow! You what? Bastard!
Ah!
You piece of shit! What the fuck's the matter with you? What the fuck is the matter with you? Oh, damn, Santo. You saved my life. Oh, we have many enemies round here. Oh, it's nothing unusual. People envious, you know?
Is he still alive? Do you know him?
Yeah, an old acquaintance. Oh, he spent 20 years in jail for killing his wife, who betrayed him with me. I know he'd come looking for me for revenge one day. It's just bad timing, that's all. So, go home. I'm sorry you got involved in this. Go, before anyone sees you.
Okay.
Go, I said!
Mum, I played at one of the most famous clubs in London. I'm on the newspaper. They wrote great things about me. Yes, sí, no estoy scherzando. I'm not kidding. Listen, Mum, here it is. Vinnie Saint surprises a crowd at the Marquee with a poignant performance displaying great showmanship. His songs offer well-crafted melodies executed with style and charisma. Yeah, Vinnie Saint. It's a stage name. What do you mean? Anyway, don't worry about it. Wait, aspetta. Ascolta, listen. This new act brings a wave of energy to the West End's music scene. I would strongly recommend it to anyone interested in new, original blues and rock and roll music. Larry McKay. I had the best meal in the last 5 years too. I'll come home soon. I'll book a flight as soon as I can. Yeah. Speak in a week. Baci. Okay. Grazie. Ciao. Hello, sir. Hi, Lin.
Please leave, young man.
What?
I don't want my daughter to have anything to do with you.
Well, what's the matter? What did I do wrong?
Please do as I said.
Lin, please say something. Sir, I thought you were fine with me. I love your daughter. What's going on?
Oh, please. Love? It seems you are very busy with all your ambition. What kind of love are you going to give my daughter?
But sir, I thought you loved music. I don't understand.
That's right. I do love music, and I love artists. But you don't seem to belong to any of these categories.
What? I just played the Marquee, isn't that something? I got a great review. I'm not going to be a penniless musician anymore. I could give Lynn a good life.
A good life? Huh. My daughter don't need your charity, young man. As you can see, we already have everything. Now please leave.
Lynn, what's wrong?
Dad, I'm sure he doesn't know. He's just a musician.
We already have a rotten apple in our family. I don't want another one. Are you crazy, Ling? What is wrong with you?
Santo, good boy. Well done. Harry told me everything about your show.
Yeah, it was a dream come true, Mr. DiMarco.
The newspaper wrote great things. You made us very proud. Your next show's in 2 weeks and all tickets have already been pre-sold. There's a lot of interest building around you. Did Harry pay you?
Yeah, he did. Thank you so much. The band also sent their regards. I also had a great meal at Bianchi with the guys.
Good. Glad to know you enjoyed it. It's the best Italian restaurant in town. Scotch?
Oh, yes, please.
How's it going with that girl you told me about? Did she come and see your show?
Well, yeah, she did, but for some reason her father won't let me see her now and won't explain why. She wouldn't even talk to me when I last saw her. I think she was afraid to speak in front of him.
No, families. Yeah, sometimes they can be your worst enemy. Here, have a smoke.
Thank you, Mr. DeMille, but I don't smoke.
Oh, come on, kid, don't be a man. You try one of these, you'll feel better. Don't worry, it won't kill you.
Smoke it. If you're tired, smoke it. When you're wired, smoke it. And nothing else to do. Lighter. Monte Cristo, have it. In San Francisco, smoke it. And let it color you. This world will keep on spinning anyhow. There'll be no change if smoking then or now. Throw your worries and frustrations deep down in the trash. 'Cause if you got the cash, You gotta smoke it in the morning, smoke it without warning, smoke it. The world will smile at you. Deep down in the trash, 'cause if you got the cash, you gotta smoke it in the morning, smoke it without warning, smoke it. The world will smile at you.
Harry.
Yes, Mr. DeMaio.
Would you please make sure Santa has some fun? We ought to keep our star happy, don't we?
Sure. We'll have a party at our club down Rupert Street. Night out of the show.
Good. I spoke with our friend at Bloom Records. He'll come and see the concert. Did you book the studio, Harry?
Yes, I did, Mr. DeMaio. We'll record in 3 songs this week, and on top of that, we'll print out a few.
Bloom Records? Are you serious?
Yes. I asked them to consider distributing your songs. So make sure you give them a good one, my boy.
Oh, you can count on it, Mr. DeMaio. I won't let you down.
I know, Santo. I know.
Lynn! Hey!
Oh, thought you wouldn't come.
Actually, I just got home. I found your note. I was busy at the studio.
With DeMaio?
Do you know?
Why didn't you tell me? Do you have any idea who he is?
Oh, God. Yes, I do. Now, you two, what's wrong with the guy?
What's wrong with him? Are you serious? What's wrong with you? I can't see you anymore, Santa.
Well, I kind of guessed it from your strange behavior the other day, but why? What have I done? If it wasn't for DeMaio, I wouldn't be where I am now. And you? You wouldn't be wearing that necklace.
Perfect. Here, have it.
Hey, what's the matter, Lynn?
DeMaio's men extort money from us each month. You have no idea who you're in business with. Your manager, Harry, he broke one of my father's legs years ago because he refused to pay him. We have no choice. Nobody protects us, and my father, he's all I have left. I can't be with someone like you.
Don't worry, I'll talk to DeMaio. I'm sure that if he knows you're my girlfriend, he'll make an exception.
My God, you sound like one of them.
What do you mean?
You don't even realize. You've already accepted their ways. I guess you just are the Italian cliche you despise so much.
Well, would you have liked it better if I stayed anonymous and broke forever then?
Oh, that's right. You really are quite something, aren't you? You're Vinnie Saint. I forgot. You were not anonymous to me, but now you are. Goodbye, Santo. Good luck with your exciting new life.
Wait! Why didn't you tell me about Harry before?
Because I feel ashamed. I wish I could change something, but I can't. And my brother...
Your brother? What does he have to do with all this?
He's a criminal too. And guess what? I couldn't change him either. And now you? It's like I'm jinxed.
A criminal? Wasn't he in Hong Kong for business? I'm not a criminal.
You see, your beautiful prostitute isn't much different than Sicily, is it?
Wait, Lynn!
Leave me alone!
Lynn!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Marquee. Now, I want you to please give a warm welcome to the new rising star of British blues, Vinnie Saint!
You love it when I hold you and tell you that you're mine.
You love it when I kiss you. You say we stop the time. It feels much more than heaven. Sometimes doesn't seem true. Something says I'm more in love than you. You loved it when I bought you the precious of your dreams. You said before you met me your life had been so grim. You say with me you're not alone and that you're gonna stay. But I know you're gonna walk away one day. Walk away. Keep searching for the perfect dream. One you can switch on and off like a TV screen. Walk away. Keep searching for the holy grail. My wishes and my blessing, not owning or possessing you. You need me when you're feeling low, when your soul starts to bleed. But then my love is taming you. You need your space to breathe. And though you like to play your notes, my score is left unplayed. I know you're gonna walk away one day. Walk away. Keep looking for the perfect man. One who'd like to be loved just when you think you can. Walk away. Make sure you wear some ragged shoes. A rainy path will follow. I feel hollow. But I got the blues.
Give one more hand to our champion. Now, Vinnie has just been offered a great contract by Bloom Records, who bought the exclusive rights to his songs for the world. Soon we'll hear our boy on radio and television. So, enjoy yourselves. Vinnie will be with you in a minute. Hey, boy. Would you please tell me what the fuck is the matter with you? You look like you've been run over by a bus. Worse than last night, out of the show.
Do you remember that girl? I mean, the one you met outside the Marquee the other night.
Oh, yeah. What, the Jack Bird? What's her name? Ling Ping?
Lin. Her name is Lin. She's actually Chinese.
All right. Well, what about her?
I really liked her.
And?
She dumped me because I work with you.
What? What's the problem with that? Like, what did I do wrong?
She said you broke her father's leg when he refused to pay you the protection money.
What? Come on, that's bollocks. Protection? Now, look, come on, think about it. Do you think we need to collect peanuts from a little Chinese bakery? Nah, she's just making excuses not to tell you the truth. We got bigger business to take care of.
Oh, I see. Look, Harry, I ain't stupid. I know you're not in the property business. Stop lying to me.
Sure we are, son. We own people.
Okay, I'm leaving.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Sit down, sit down. Well, What do you think you want to do, eh? Look, it's no big deal. If you like her so much, maybe Mr. DeMayo will make an exception.
How ironic.
What?
Nothing.
Listen, boy.
What you worried about? You got family now. Can't you see it? We're all here just for you, celebrating the news. Please don't kill it. And now look at them girls, just pick one and kaboom, all your sadness soon be gone. Dive right into that flesh, just forget, and tomorrow will bloom. There's no buts, there's no ifs, there's no maybe, what ifs, only here and now. Do you remember your past? It was gone in a blast since we found you. And now look at these bums, how can you pick just one? Don't be stupid. Just enjoy it, Marquee, before shutting the lid. Mark my words. She ain't for you, she ain't with you, she ain't for no one. Who needs a woman who don't like fire? You know there's no fun. She ain't for you, she ain't with you, she don't deserve your blue toe. You're no babysitter, no chaperone, so let her be gone. You think she will care if you went on the moon? Please, don't kid yourself. You're about to take off, she's already gone off, put you on a shelf. But don't worry, my friend, there'll be plenty for you till this family's your home. And as long as you're here, there'll be nothing to fear. Sing your blues. She ain't for you, she ain't with you, she ain't for no one. Who needs a woman who don't love fire? You know that's no fun. She ain't for you, she ain't with you, she don't deserve your little toe. You're no babysitter, step back and face the mere truth. All right, everybody, let's have a good time.
Yeah, okay. I'm coming. Yeah, who is it? Dad? Hi, Dad. How are you? What do you mean, bad news? What? How did it happen? Why didn't she tell me? Why didn't you tell me then? Okay, but maybe I could have. Maybe I could have. When is the funeral? Yeah, I'll book a flight. Yeah, okay. You take care of that. I'll see you soon. Bye.
You're right, darling.
You too. Get the fuck out of here, now!
Oh my God, you're crazy!
Tu sei scema proprio!
Leave me alone, you fucking whore!
Ow! Ma vaffanculo, va!
I'm sorry, my boy. I'm really sorry.
She never told me she was ill.
Oh, we'll be your family from now on. But your recording session for the single is next week at the Marquee Studios. Is it too early for you? Do you think you can still do it?
I don't know. I need to go home for the funeral, but I guess I'll be back by then. I need to do something not to think about it. I guess I'll be fine. I'll be fine.
Well, as I said, we're family. Harry, give me those tickets. Here you go, kid. First class.
I don't know what to say.
Don't worry. You pay my regards to your father.
Grazie, Mr. Di Mel.
Harry told me about the girl. He said you liked her very much. Unfortunately, her father gave us problems in the past, you know.
Mr. Di Mel, please, leave her alone. You had a wife once. Don't you remember what it's like to love someone?
How do you... Thanks, Harry. Some of your business, kid.
Hey, Santo, shut it.
I beg you. You own me, right? I got nothing to lose anymore. Please, she's been the only sweet thing in my life. If I can't have her, couldn't you let her be happy at least?
I don't know, Santo. I mean, why'd you care so much about her? There are women everywhere.
Kid, go over it.
Shut it, Harry. Oh, you love her, eh? I can see that. Okay. We've got a deal. You have my word.
Thank you.
Harry, where is Rocco?
He went to Italy. Zach, the idiot, has been spreading rumours about him. We thought it'd be a safety measure.
Oh, really? And why didn't you tell me?
There was no time. Detective Reed was already looking for him, so he got on a first flight available.
Okay. I think it's time to put the frighteners on Fat Zach. Harry, do what you do best.
Oh, lovely. With pleasure. Santo, do you want to come with me?
Zach. Zach! Yeah. Let's go. Hey, Zach. I missed you so much. I thought I'd come say hello.
Good God. You again?
Look, pal, you know the rules. Are you trying to fuck us up?
What are you talking about?
Rocco had to leave the country because of you, pal. Reed was looking for him.
I swear to God. I didn't say nothing.
Oh, shut the fuck up. We just know, you fat slob.
Okay, then. What are you do, you bloody ratty? I got nothing to lose anyway. You DiMeos make my life a fucking nightmare. Now I'm tired of this shit. Fuck off!
Santo, do you believe this prick? What would you do if you was me?
So now, you got the minstrel boy with you. What do you need him for? Advice on the latest record purchases? You mugs are pathetic.
I hate a dirty mind knife. But for you, I'll make an exception.
Ah, shit! My leg. Okay.
Look at him.
Stop, please.
Look at him. You're not laughing anymore, Zach. Are you?
What the fuck is wrong with you, son? Get off my leg! Get off my leg!
You laughed and you lied. For the tears that I cried. And without any shame, you just kept me your slave. For hours and hours. In your dirty canteen, I was singing my soul out. You were killing my dreams. Look who's laughing now. There ain't no escape to your wine. But don't worry, my friend. In the place you're going to, you'll be food for the demons. They're all waiting for you. Look at you now. Just begging for mercy. The lamb's now a tiger. And the jackals are flirting.
Look who's laughing now. There ain't no escape to your petty fate. That's right, look who's laughing now. You got nowhere to hide. See you on the other side.
Don't you understand, son? You think you're better than me? You and me are no different. You're working for them too. I'm sure you're enjoying the ride right now, but soon you'll have to pay the fucking price.
Harry, give me that gun.
Santo, what are you doing, son? Give it back. Come on.
All we're going to do now, kill me? Whatever. Do it. Do it! I'm tired of working my tits off your degenerative breed. Goddamn the challenge, you could only cook, rob, and fuck.
Shut up!
By the way, Detective Reed knows about you already. He'll be on your ass pretty soon.
Bullshit.
How's your mummy gonna feel now you've become a gangster? Or perhaps that's just the way she raised you, you son of a peasant whore.
Sanso, what the fuck did you do?
Harry, how did this happen? Didn't we say we don't want any publicity? And you were there. Why didn't you stop him?
Really sorry, Don DeMaio. I didn't expect it. The kid, he just lost it.
I shouldn't have let him come with you in that state.
Before dying, Zach said the Detective Reed had been investigating. Apparently, he's even listened to Santo's phone conversations.
Okay, let's keep calm. Extreme solutions for extreme situations. Santo, I'm afraid we're going to have to let you go, my boy.
Let me go? What? No, I'm really sorry. I didn't mean it. I don't know what happened to me. Please help me, Mr. DeMille. I've never used a gun before.
You represent a grave danger for us, Santo. We put you under the spotlight. But now the light is too bright. We can't get exposed because of you.
But you lose a lot of money, right? And what are you going to tell Bloom Records?
Oh, wow. You are ambitious, are you? I'm impressed. You got balls. Oh, I give you that. Fuck your rock and roll bullshit. This is going to cost us more than that, kid. Bye now. Harry, get him out of my face.
Sorry, son. It was out of my hands.
No, wait. Please. Please, what am I going to do now?
Leave. Get that flight and leave this town and go back to Sicily. This is my last offer to you. Take it. And thank my daughter if I don't send you to sing with the angels.
Your daughter?
Yes. Lorna, my ungrateful daughter.
You won't hear me say on a sunny stage. You won't hear me play for a lousy wage. You won't see me shining of the TV lights. You'll hear my voice in the dead of night. If you can't find me, just chase the flames. Ask the devil, call my name. Deep down in the gutter, my music rains. A prayer's bread and a promise made. You'll find me smiling, what's good to say? Far away from angels, far away from pain. If you can't find me, leave out she sings as the devil called my name. In the dreamer's cradle, I will feed your vice. Won't you take my hand? I won't lead you astray. Welcome to my world. Let me lead the way. There ain't nothing wrong. There ain't nothing right. If you can't find me, ask the devil tonight. Ask the devil tonight. Ask the devil tonight.
God, what have I done? Dad? Hi. I know it's early. I couldn't sleep. I'm sorry. I just wanted to tell you that I love you. I know. I'm sorry if we didn't talk much lately. I'll be home tomorrow night. Yeah. Don't worry. I'm okay. Yeah. Now, yeah. The music's going well. Very well. Go back to sleep. I'm sorry again if I woke you. Yeah, see you soon. Ciao. Take care. Yeah? Who is it?
Leonard Reed, Metropolitan Police.
Oh, shit. Okay. Okay.
Open the door, Mr. LaRosa. We need to talk.
Hello, Detective. Please, come in.
Yeah, thank you. Such a big artist living in such a small pad.
Well, I like this neighborhood, you know. I wouldn't move elsewhere.
Yeah, sure. Look, Santo, we know you work with DeMeo, so I'd advise you to collaborate. Your life will be easier, believe me. So, did he order the murder of Zach Abrahams?
I don't know. How would I know, Detective?
Before he was found dead, Abrahams told me they were extorting money from him. He even said one of them beat him to collect money for you.
For me? Really? What for? That's ridiculous. I'm just a musician.
Look, son, this matter's really, really serious. I understand you're afraid and don't want to undermine your career, but these people are vicious. If you're afraid of losing your job, rest assured you'll keep it. If you collaborate, I'll guarantee your name will stay clean.
I understand, Mr. Reed, but I really don't know anything. They tell me when to sing and I do, as simple as that. I have no knowledge of their business.
I think you do. All right. Here's my business card. Give me a call once you're ready.
Sure thing.
Well, I guess we're done here. Be wise, son. Trust me. Be wise. Have a safe flight. We'll talk again on your return. I hope.
Okay, Detective. Thank you. Goodbye. God. What am I gonna do now? Yeah. Come in, Detective. Rocco. You're back.
Hello, Cherry Blossom. How we doing? Hand it over, then.
Here, Mr. Harry.
Let's see. Who's this?
Mr. Harry, I apologise, but we don't have as much as you need this month. I'm really sorry.
Look, kid, I don't buy into your sorry bullshit. It probably means that your cakes ain't good enough. All right? What should I do then, eh? Tell me!
I don't know.
Come here. Maybe you need more sugar to make them better, eh? Oh, your hair smells lovely. And you taste good too.
Please, Mr. Harry, I'll pay you next month.
Next month? Shut up! You know the rules. You have to keep your mouth shut. And it seems you've forgotten about that, Lynn. Am I right?
Oh.
Leave my daughter alone!
Dad!
Stay away, old man. Do you want me to put you on a fucking wheelchair this time?
I hope you rot in hell.
We're getting feisty here. This is fun, isn't it? It's the icing on the cake, right?
Hello, Father. Hi, Sister.
Ming? What are you doing here?
Voice I'm hearing here, this is not the time for prayers. I know of your dirty deeds. What do you want from God?
Oh, please, Father, don't reject me. I have nowhere else to go. I pray God that He'll protect me and restore my soul.
Holy Father, cleanse this sinner.
The Evaristo Club is closed for renovations and will reopen to the public in the beginning of 1969. That's weird. Lorna didn't mention anything.
Hey! Hey, Vinny!
Oh, hey, Rocco.
Come with me, son. Let's go for a little walk.
I can't. I need to go to the airport.
Yeah, I know. But just a few minutes of your time. I'll give you a lift if you want. Don DeMeo wants to talk to you. You know he regrets what he did. He told me to come and find you.
Really?
Yeah, of course. You know, sometimes the heat of the moment makes you do stupid things. Don DeMeo is getting old. He really loses temper sometimes, and he tends to jump to conclusions.
So you mean I could still play the marquee and the recordings and all?
Well, that's sorted. I spoke with him. I didn't say nothing about your meeting with Reed, and I know you kept your mouth shut, right? It'd be nuts to waste all the work we did. Look, I'm glad he's changed his mind.
Oh, that's great news.
Well, it took me a while to convince him, but I always have faith in you, son, and I love your music. You know that.
Oh, thank you, Rocco. Thank you so much.
Yeah, come here. Give us a hug. It's all going to be all right.
Hey, what are you going to do with that gun? Why?
I'm sorry, son. But I've got no choice.
What have I done to you? You're the one who pulled me into this mess, Rocco. Just let me go.
Now shut up! Don't make it harder. I've got to do what I've been told. That's it. It's nothing personal, son.
Oh, I see. So you want to be taking orders from the mail like a puppy for the rest of your life? What a privilege.
Shut up, I said.
Go for it, then. You made me lose everything good I had anyway. Kill me, big boy. Come on. But at least give me a fucking good reason.
Well, someone killed Harry in your bird shop. And I wonder who did that.
And you think I did? Look, my life's already a mess. My mother just died. Reed knows all my moves. Do you really think I'd be so dumb?
Fuck this!
I saw your eyes in tears when I was playing. And you wanted to shoot me? And for what? I know you hate this kind of life. At least be honest with yourself.
Look, kid. Don't you push your luck here. Get the fuck out of here! Go!
Bye, Rocco.
Vatin! It really shit him up, didn't you, son? You put the fright on him, all right. Let the mad dogs out. Let the mad dogs out. Let them scream. I'll tell you, I'm the mad dog.
Hands up.
What?
Let's go for a walk, Mr. Patelli.
Hold up. Who are you?
Lynn. Hi.
Oh, hi.
Can I come in? Is your father here? Can we talk?
My dad's at the hospital. Harry hurt him again.
But Rocco just told me Harry is dead.
He is. My brother killed him, in fact. What do you want?
What do you mean your brother killed him? Your brother's in London? I just wanted to say...
Don't worry. The triads are here. Things will change now. My brother's one of the bosses.
Your brother's in the triads. Really? Great. Wow. So, Hey, maybe you'll own Jarrah Street now, right? You're free. I thought you were ashamed of your brother. And ashamed of me as well, right? Well, now you understand. We all have demons. Goodbye, Lynn. I'm leaving.
Wait. Why are you leaving?
I'm leaving because I need to go.
Wait.
What? What, Lynn? It's all over, don't you understand? It's all fucking over! I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I didn't want to hurt you. I didn't want anybody to hurt you. I didn't want to hurt anybody. Please, let me go now. I just wanted to make sure you didn't hate me. That's all. I gotta go.
But what are you gonna do now?
I am gonna be happy in Sicily. The way my father wants.
Yes, come in. Did you find the kid? Who's this?
Look, sorry, Don DeMayo. I looked all over for him. Your daughter's club was shut. I couldn't find him there either. I did find a witness of Harry's murder, though. His family's got a shop on Gerrard Street.
Damn, how do we know the kid won't talk to Reed? I mean, we must have slowed you down, you giant idiot. All right. All right, at least there's one good piece of news. What does this ching have to say, then?
I perfectly understand English, sir. So please do not call me Chink. Call me by my family's name if you wish.
Unbelievable. I mean, what's the matter with these people now? We protect them, allow them to be where they are and make their money. And now they want to give us orders. And what would your name be then? Chink. Oh, please. Rocco, this band again. Do me a favour. Switch off the radio, would you? What are you doing? Are you deaf? Switch off the radio, I said. Wait, what the hell is going on, Rocco? His hand. Do something.
My name is Charming. I am the one who killed your man. Now please, accept my protection.
After losing his way, put his heart in a pocket and then decided to change. He said, saints and them sinners ain't no different to me. That's the reason I left home and all my holy things.
We're getting reports of two more murders in London, Soho. Suspected crime boss Alberto Di Meo was found dead last night, just one day after one of his longtime associates, Harry Cox, now identified as a local debt collector, was killed in Gerrard Street. There continues to be an ongoing search for the man identified as Di Meo's consigliere, Rocco Vitali. Scotland Yard's Detective Reed has declared that the investigation into the West End criminal underworld is still ongoing, but these new events have shifted attention towards the Triads. The Triads are a known Hong Kong crime organisation who have been suspected of activity in the upcoming New Chinatown area in Gerrard Street. As always, we'll keep you posted. This is John Warnaby for BBC Radio News. Good night.
In my town fell an angel and his soul turned to black. He was saved by a demon and he never
favorite street. I'm sure you won't believe the kind of folks you're gonna meet. There's winging to the left, there's winging to the right. A few too many drinks and too many lonely nights. They live as if they knew the world is gonna finish soon. And when they feel low, they start howling at the moon.
Let the mad dogs out. Let the mad dogs out. Let them scream and shout. Let the mad dogs out. Let the mad dogs out. Let them scream and shout out loud.
A Mary 63, but she thinks she's still 18. She once fell off her bike and then she lost her memory. She's winging to the left, she's winging to the right. She loves a miniskirt, funky nails and purple tights. And when a cheeky fella says, "Hey, beautiful, what's up?" she says, "I'm sorry, baby, you're too old to pick me up."
Let the mad dogs out. Let the mad dogs out. Let them scream and shout. Let the mad dogs out. Let the mad dogs out. Let them scream and shout out loud.
Joy, he hasn't yet decided he's a girl or he's a boy. He's winging everywhere, no matter what they say. He finds it very boring to be normal every day. On Monday, call me Luke. On Tuesday, call me Sue. On every other day, I'll be whatever's good for you.
Let the mad dogs out. Let the mad dogs out. Let them scream and shout. Let the mad dogs out. Let the mad dogs out. Let them scream and shout out loud. Let the mad dogs out. Let them scream and shout out loud. Let the mad dogs out. Scream and shout out loud.